Right. Welcome everyone to the first streamed 29th scrim. And what you're going to see today is
User joined your channel.
one of the matches that we run within the 29th. We're going to be showing you the kind of battles we have between the platoons within the 29th. The platoon, for those of you not up on the army jargon, is just a group of guys that work together as a team. Really, that's what it's going to be. And today, I'm joined with a couple of special guests. First, I've got First Sergeant Sear, one of the veteran members of the 29th. How you doing, Sear?
Doing pretty good. How about you?
I'm doing great. I'm so excited. It's the first time we're going to be streaming something just like this. So, yeah, I'm really excited to see how it goes, and I'm hoping we see a good battle today. And we have one more guest joining us today, and this guy, you might have seen him around in the Darkest Hour Battalion server. He's a renowned pubber, Dave Fern. Welcome to your first 29th event, Dave.
Hey, what up? Thanks a lot, man. I'm really excited. I'm filled with a child's excitement right now to watch some Darkest Hour action. And I just hope for a good game, you know? Just good game.
And this is brand new to you because the guys that are in the 29th, excuse me, guys that are in the 29th, they've actually, been part of these kind of battles before. But you've seen public gameplay, playing the maps like they are designed to be played. This can be the first time you've seen an actual 29th match, correct?
Yeah, you're right. I haven't seen a match with, some structure and whatnot, so I'm excited to see what these guys have got, and I'm excited to see what kind of new strategies I get to watch.
Yeah, and that's really what it's going to come down to, I think, today, strategy. Both of these teams are going to be using very similar base weapons, and the base weapon being the rifle, of course. And the rifle for both teams today is going to be bolt action. We've got the Allies today, which are Baker Platoon 2, BP2 for you guys. They're going to be using the Enfield as their weapon of choice, the main weapon that they have the most of. And we've got BP1, Baker Platoon 1, over on the Axis, and of course, the Kar 98, their weapon of choice today. And I'm throwing up the player list here, and you'll see some other weapons that are appearing on both sides. Big ones today, tanks. Sear, tanks. What are they going to do today during the scrim?
Well, tanks are hopefully going to hunt each other down and not get blown up by the anti-tank personnel.
Yeah, and I think that the big guy to watch out for is over on Allies, PFC Lita. For those of you in the 29th, we've seen some unbelievable play from Lita in the last couple weeks. So if he can pull through again with his tank, I don't know if the Axis are going to be able to take him down. Beyond just tanks, though, both teams are going to have the Tank Hunter class, and I mean, one good rocket will be able to eliminate either of these guys or either of the tanks. So I don't know. It's pretty exciting. I think that the dynamics between the anti-tank and the tank are going to be a really big thing to this scrim because I guess I should explain the rules to some of the non-29th guys that might be watching this. This is going to be a one life, no respawn round. So both of these teams, we're looking at a 29 versus 30. They're going to be playing with no respawns. So they're going to start in a certain location. They're going to have a certain objective, and they're going to need to use their 30 men approximately to accomplish that objective. As people die, they will not be reinforced. So if you lose your tank, you're not getting another one. If you lose your BAR or your FG, you're not getting another one. You really have to be smart and use some strategy with these guys because you throw a lot of guys away and you're going to be on the back foot.
They're looking ready.
Yeah, and this is just something we do within the 29th is both these teams are going to take the time to give out the weapons to the guys that they want to actually have these weapons. So for a fair match, they've discussed between each other, the Allies and the Axis leaders, of course, how many weapons they want to have on each side. And tough negotiations sometimes go down with how many BARs you want to have compared to how many MP40s and
Of
stuff like
course.
that. I'm a large supporter of the BAR over the MP40, so I'd be
Well, the
arguing for
BAR is
those.
kind of the most overpowered gun in the game, so it's pretty easy to support it.
Yeah, if you're an ally, of course.
Of course.
Well, they're just setting up and giving the guns to the guys they want to have them because there's a lot of skilled guys on each of these platoons on each side, and you want to make sure the right guy gets the right weapon. So the leaders are sending them out to the people they want.
Okay, let's have a look at the teams. I'm looking at the list right now, trying to look for some recognizable names. There's Janch over there on the Axis team, and Maloney.
Yeah, Janch and Maloney, these are two guys that actually play quite a bit in our battalion server.
Yeah, they play pub a lot.
Very strong riflemen, both of them. Janch is one of the stronger riflemen we have in all of Baker Company, so nice to see him with the rifle instead of something more like the heavy like he's also played as.
We got, I guess Lar is he going to be playing tank for the Axi?
No, Lar's actually going to be using the MP40 today, so going to see him mash some guys down.
Doing some mashing.
And
all right, let's go over to allies here. What do we got going on? We got Evanson, who was just speaking in chat there.
Yeah, Staff Sergeant Evanson.
Recognize that one.
Yeah, Staff Sergeant Evanson is actually going to be one of the leaders of the allies today. He's working with Second Lieutenant Derbyshire to form the plan and make sure the plan actually goes down.
Okay, so I've enabled match mode. I'll also enable power drop so we can drop out.
All right, so we're getting into it. Match mode is now on. Neither team.
Here we go.
Both these teams are in the match mode, which is the 29th game mode
for
running these matches.
Looks like me and Lieutenant Darby are in charge of the admin now. So I've enabled match mode, enabled power drops. I guess we can drop out to starting locations. I'll have a little briefing time. From match live, it'll be 1 hour. Whoever controls the silence out at the end of the hour is the winner. If it's contested, overtime is announced until there is a clear team in control of the silo. At that point, they win.
All right, so he explained it better than I ever could.
Lieutenant Browning and First Sergeant, Staff Sergeant Lev will be refereeing. And at the end of that hour, they'll decide who's won. If it's still contested at the end of the hour, it'll play on in overtime until they're happy someone's in full control of the silo. Lieutenant Darby, do you have anything to add on to that?
And again, he described the scenario better than I ever could, so I'm looking at it right now.
Out then, I guess Axis obviously starts at the South Village approach. Canadians, you guys start at Pluto North End. Good luck. Let's drop out.
This right here, what I'm looking at right here is going to be the objective. So, the silo tower, one of the bigger buildings on the entire map. It's going to be square in the middle of both their starting positions. And I'm going to fly up a little high, and you're going to get a good view of this if you've never actually seen Putat. But it's just some wide flanks on both sides of this silo tower. So either of these teams can take these massive flanks around. If they want to get here. They can also just go straight down the road if
obviously,
they're...
we're setting up. Make sure you're inside the cap point itself. You can't start from outside, obviously. So until it's live, you have to stay within the cap point.
Alright, so either team can do big flank around, or they could go straight at the silo tower if that's what they so desire. It'll be a one-hour round, so we're in for the long haul today. I guess it really depends how aggressive both these teams are. Both these teams really go for the kill. You kill everybody on the other side, and that's a win as well. So nice to see what kind of strategies we see. I'm expecting first platoon, the Axis today. I'm expecting a lot of aggression out of them. They've shown aggression in the past. I think that if there's anyone that's going to actually go for the kill today, it's going to be the Axis team. The Allies, though, I don't know. Like I said, they've got some really strong tankers over there, and with a strong tanker, you never know what could happen. So, I'm looking for the starting positions of these teams here right now, and I'll just pop into the player view so I can get a good idea. All right, so we've seen the Allies; they're over there. And the Axis is going to be starting over in the south of Village, so the Allies will be over in the Winnipeg Rifle HQ, and the Axis will be over in the South Village. So they've got a pretty big run over to the silo tower before they actually get to it. And that'll allow for even more maneuvering and all that. First Sergeant Sear, you mind watching the the Axis start location for me? I want to get some ideas of what they're going to be planning.
Alright.
I'm slowly flying over, a very slow bird, over to the Allies start location. And I'll try and get a view so we can see what the Allies are going to be planning. Usually, just based on what we see from how they're lining up in their spawn areas, we'll get a good idea of what their actual plan is. If you got a lot of guys standing over to the west, you can probably expect a flank to the west or you know, any direction like that. Alright, Dave, our guest Dave is DC'd, but I think he's gotten back in. Are you back in yet, Dave?
I'm having some technical difficulties right now. I did get back into the server, but it said I got forcibly removed.
Ah!
But I'm just really having a hard time connecting to the server.
Interesting.
We'll see.
Alright. We'll see what's going on. If worse comes to worse, you should actually be able to watch the stream. There should only be a couple seconds delay, so it shouldn't be overly bad if necessary.
If worse comes to worse, I'll tell you what, man. I would just have to cry and break out into tears, because this is not something I want to miss.
Honesty at its finest.
Alright, here we go. I'm loading. Alright, my friend, so explain to me, are we waiting for the beginning here, or what's going on?
Yeah, both these teams are just taking their time to set up in their start location, and we're going to see them sort out who they're going to be wanting to go in each direction here. They've got a bit of room to play with in these starting locations. So you're seeing on Allies here, they're setting up a couple guys over in this general direction, and I don't want to reveal too much here. In case people are listening, but they're sending in a bunch of allies on this general direction, and that should lead for a really, really, really quick sprint right through there. Oh, free roam. Yes, it is the melee button to switch spectating views. Melee button.
Beautiful. That finally just worked for me.
How are the Axis looking? Are they splitting up nicely in their spawn areas here?
We're a little bit scattered about. I think they're keeping spacing for any early artillery strikes or mortars. I can't remember if anyone grabbed mortars.
Yeah.
But, they seem to be getting their plan worked out here down at the railway underpass, which is where they're sitting there.
Yeah, and that's really the big thing here. And I'm going to open up the maps so you guys can see. The Allies here all the way at Putat North End. The Axis all the way at South Village Approach Railway Underpass area. These guys are pretty far away from each other. They are not close. So we're going to get to see a lot of positioning before the actual shooting starts. And I'm going to take a look here to see if there is any mortars on each team. And we do have at least mortar observers on Axis. I'm not sure if there's an actual mortar on Axis, but there's at least a mortar observer. And if there's a mortar on each team, they know where the enemy's starting, and they could dial in the positions and try and go for some early shenanigan spawn strikes. That's yet to be seen, though. Again, this match is not yet live. We're still in the preparation phase. So both these teams are giving the plans out to the men. The leaders are sorting out what everyone's going to do. And once they've got that all sorted, we're going to see both teams ready. Ready it up, if you will. And then we're going to go live. And this is an interesting strategy by the Allies, and I'm liking this. They're doing a big stack on their actual tank. And this is going to allow these Allies on the tank to get up a lot further than they normally would just sprinting. So they're going to get a hit crew flying up as far as possible on this tank before needing to jump off. And that'll give these guys an absolutely massive positioning advantage.
Interestingly enough, there's some Axis piled onto the Axis tank as well. So a similar strat going on over on this side as well.
Ah, beautiful. That's interesting that both these teams would be going for the same thing. And this is something that's very risky normally. Because if your tank gets blown up and there's a bunch of people on it, you could die. Of course, these teams are very far away from each other again. So there's really no risk as to these guys getting blown up once the round starts. They're gonna at least a minute, maybe two, before they hit enemy contact. Really depends on how aggressive both these teams play.
I'm really hoping we could see some good aggression here at the beginning of the map.
Yeah, and it's
all new
quite
to me,
possible.
But I really hope their strategy involves some sort of sprinting forward.
I mean, there is an hour of time that they can use for their strategies, so we might see a little bit of a slow burn as both these teams just suss out the enemy's position before doing too much. It's really really in question what the teams want to do, though. You know, if I was on one of these teams leading it, I know personally I'd be trying to predict where the enemies were going to be and then trying to counter that prediction. You know, you can get a lot of freebies that way. What about you, First Sergeant Seer? You've done some leading. What would you do if you're in the Axis position right now? Would you take it slow, suss out the opponents, or would you try and force yourself into a strong position right from the get-go?
Well, considering the distance that they spawn from each other, there is a lot of no man's land in between. So you probably want to do a hard, aggressive push to grab as much early land as you can. But when you start getting close to the middle ground there, where the action will most likely start breaking out, you'll probably want to play a little bit slow at first and test the waters a bit before making your move.
Man, that's a good plan as well. I guess it really comes down to preference, you know. I've always been one for throwing caution to the wind and just, you know, going all in and taking the risks. Big risk, big reward, right? All right, and again.
That's very true too, but you usually see a lot of slower plays with a lot of commanders.
Yeah, and I think it's a lot to do with they don't want to. You can lose very quickly with a big risk. You can win very quickly, but you can lose very quickly. And I think they're going to put a lot more faith in their actual men's personal skills. You know, these guys, they work pretty hard to get good at this game. So these commanders are going to put a lot of weight behind the actual skill of their guys. And a slow game will allow their men more time to show their skills. And while I was talking, the allies are ready. One of the teams is prepared for battle. We're going to see the allies, or the Axis, hopefully ready out very slowly. And I'm getting excited. I'm getting very excited to see what's going to happen here.
Yeah, I'm starting to get the jitters here. I'm really getting pretty pumped up to see what's going to happen.
You know, I've got my eye on this guy right here. This guy with his Sten. He's looking at his buddies. I don't think he's going to shoot them, but he's giving them the eyes. And we're off.
Here we go.
Alright, we're going to follow the Allied tank from spawn here and see where it sets up, because this is going to be very telling of what their plan is. They're going to want to set this tank up in a position where he can cut off a part of the map. You don't want to walk into HE rounds, and this tank, yeah, it's got HE rounds, alright.
Alright, well, I'm watching the Axis spawn here. Guys to keep an eye for, PFC Rogers is holding that Panzer Shrek. So he's, watch out for him to be looking for the tank kill.
And he is actually a pretty well-known Panzer Shrek user. He's one of the older members here
right?
In the 29th, and he's got a lot of experience with that weapon. He is a killer. Stone cold.
Speaking of Stone Cold Killers, we also have Janch in here.
And you've had a grudge with Janch.
I can't wait to see this guy make some shots.
I can tell just by how much
you
mentioned it.
Me and Janch, we go back a ways. You know, I just love shooting that guy. And,
who doesn't?
I hope he has some fun shooting me too, so.
And this is a beautiful play from the Allies. We've got the Allies who were riding that tank, and they brought a very quick mobile force over to the church here. So they used the mobility of the tank to get a lot of guys up to the church very quickly. And I'm going to fly up in the church for you guys. And this has got some very nice sight lines on this map. This church can see a lot, and they can cover a whole wide berth of a flank. The other side here, we popped over to Corporal Yarvinen, and beautiful prone technique over a wall. He's making some moves over towards this. They're getting close to the silo here. Oh, we got a suicide somehow.
It was over on Axis set here. I did not see how it happened, but that's always a shame.
His game ended quickly.
Yeah, and that could be one of many things. He might have just disconnected, which would be the best possible situation, but guy like Axis, so.
Oh, picked off. Domed.
Wow, and there goes one of their leaders. That is a really big loss for the Allies. That's one of the two leaders of the team down.
And once again, that same guy with the K98. Same guy, same building. He's really covering a lot here.
Yeah, PFC
Benton. Exactly where he was.
Yeah, he is pulling his weight. He's not messing around. And this is just... It's getting worse and worse, I feel, for these Allies. The Axis, they've got really nice buildings, really nice sight lines. And unless the Allies can make something happen, I think they're just going to keep losing these small skirmishes. And all the windows of this building are too small for me to squeeze out of.
You can do it.
No, I can't. I gave up.
Just believe in that you could do it, and anything is possible.
If only Darkest Hour was a Disney movie, then I might have to agree with you. We're going to need to see some belief from the Allies, belief that they can still win this one, because I'm not seeing anything from them yet. They're just not doing what they need to do to get the win. They need to make some, not only plays, they need to make some kills. It seems that their guys are just not properly predicting how much territory the Axis have covered. Everyone that's seen an Axis has been killed by that Axis, so it's not working too well for them. We got some more gunfire coming out now.
Now, this I don't like to see. I'm back in that building where the Axis machine gun was at the beginning, and we got a guy with a masher, an MP40, and he's just kind of camping a door.
Well, he might not know where the enemies are, so...
Well, of course he doesn't know. But, you know, the guys with the mash, gotta get a mash in. They gotta make some moves.
Speaking of not liking what you see with the MP40, this right here, prone at the top of the stairs, it's just not the best position. Here we go, now he's moving. He's being a bit more smart. You're prone at the top of the stairs, you're gonna get shot in the hands. No one's gonna have a good time.
Gonna have a bad time.
Yeah. And wow, this is...
I'm liking the patience from this Allied tank.
Well, the Allied tank has been... the superstar for not going too forward and going for the kill. When you know where the enemies are like he has, and I'm sure the rest of the Allies have, you know, told them, we've got access in this building, we've got access in this building, but he's waiting it out, and he's got to be telling his team, I can't move forward unless you tell me that there's no anti-tank, you know. Even if they just clip me with one of those rockets, you know, he could lose his treads and not be able to drive. He could lose his gun sight and not be able to aim. There's so many bad things that can happen to him if he gets in range, and he needs to get close to kill these Axis, so it's a risk-reward for him.
Yeah, he knows exactly what he needs to do, so he's just going to chill there and do that. We're looking at some Allied movement at the church. We've got a little squad making some moves.
Yeah, and I think these are the guys that really need to make the moves. They've got a lot of guys over here in this church.
Yeah, they have a crew.
And I don't know what they were doing setting up in this church. Maybe when they had run their practice matches, people had... push through their churches. You know, whenever you practice for one of these things, you see a lot of strategies that you can't just predict, and they might have seen a lot of people push through the church and get the win on them, so I think they tried to counter against that, but the Axis are having none of that. They didn't want the church. They don't want anything to do with the church. They're staying away from the church, and the Allies just got a huge force here that aren't accomplishing anything. At the end of the day, during these matches, even though this is a 60-minute match, if you're not looking at where the enemies might be, you're not accomplishing anything. Even just sitting and watching an area the Axis might move through would be a lot more beneficial than what these guys are doing. Just walking around AT guns. And
it looks like they have a general idea of what they want to do. It looks like they're going to work down this road a little bit. But they got to do that a little bit quicker. They're going to make their moves swifter.
Yeah, and I think that they don't understand. I think there's an invisible wall they're going to hit right here. I might be wrong, though. No, they can walk right through that barbed wire. Beautiful. They don't know.
This is Darkest Hour, man.
This is Darkest Hour, yeah. A barbed wire, yeah, we will walk through it. They don't know the Axis tank is watching this flank. The Axis tank is waiting for someone to try and do something like this. So this is extremely dangerous for them. And see here, He's very far away from where the allies are now, but if they keep going along this flank, they're going to run into him. And wow, what a slow-paced game, really. The Axis with some very quick moves at the start, but other than that, not much. And we've got the sniper here over on Axis. And this is Manson. He's up in a window with his sniper. Very new acquisition for the Axis team. Manson just recently returned to the 29th, and he's one of our star snipers. And wow, Private Lacey picking up another kill for the Axis. We've got some gunfire going on. It's been a while. Wow, more and more kills for this Axis team. The Allies just can't get anything.
That flank crew, somebody got picked off in there. And now they're backing up. Now they're all scattered. They're running away. So I don't know where he is, but there must have been an Axis dude laying in the bushes here somewhere waiting for that. So actually, really nice to predict that.
I found
that
them.
Great.
Yep, there's these
here he is. Got
two,
him.
Two Axis prone in these bushes, and the Allies ran right up next to them without even seeing. And this
yeah,
is
right
into
them.
This is some of the fear of Darkest Hour. Some thick bushes that they're not solid. You can shoot through them, but you cannot see through them. And the Axis abused this, and when the Allies got too close, they got some free kills out of it. And
oh my god, and those Allies ran all the way back to church. They really, that backfired.
I think they had to. I don't think they could have pushed through there. The two riflemen are not a big force, but if there's two riflemen out on the flank, you're called out. Your flank's no longer a surprise.
Right.
They're going to redirect some people over there. And wow, I'm struggling to see what the Allies can do. I'm going to get a count to see how many guys they've lost. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 guys so far down from the Allies. So that's almost a third of their team. This is a staggering, staggering amount of people who lose this early.
Seer, give us an update. What are you watching? What are you looking at?
I'm circling around the church. I had noticed some Axis sneaking around it earlier from a distance. I'm not sure if they're making moves or not yet.
I think they might
so
be content.
There might be some action here.
I think they might be content to just sit outside the church and wait for the Allies to move out again. We have Private Lacey here, who
And the Axis are very much in the safe position by just waiting. Allies are the ones who need to make some nice aggressive plays here to actually pick up the game.
Yeah,
or else they're just going to get picked off one by one continuously like they have been.
And these Axis are actually playing a very dangerous game. They know there's Allies in the church, and this church has 3 or 4 good positions that can fire upon where these guys are prone behind these bushes. So there's a guy with binoculars up there, or a guy with a scope up there on his rifle. They could get spotted out and they could get killed pretty quickly. There's no real solid cover here. Just some bushes. That's not going to stop bullets.
We got an ally with an SMG trying to make plays on the Ekashet houses. Oh no, he's actually falling back. I didn't see the angle just quite right.
That's disappointing.
Yeah.
I think it's going to come down to one of those guys. One of the STGs, one of the SMGs or one of the Brens to really make the moves. For this allied team, I can't see their Enfields really getting enough done at this point.
From the looks of the allied team, they're probably going to regroup at church, either defend or maybe make a different play.
Well, they're going to need to work
something out. A lot of them are falling back. Church has essentially become the allied Alamo here.
Yeah, and it's really, really far away from their objective.
Okay, we got allies making a move here down the road on the right side.
I'm gonna try and find these guys.
It's nice to see them actually on their feet instead of peering out of windows. So,
and they're getting shot at too. This is a they're moving from Cachette.
They don't have an angle on them. They finally made the move that they should have made a long, long time ago.
Definitely,
this
but it's only 3 Enfields. They're not going in with the big guns, and that's got to be worrying. You're going
there
inside
is a guy
building.
With a Sten around. I think one of them has a Sten, no?
Oh, you're right. Here's the Sten with the smoke in the back. And this is very dangerous, stopping in this building here.
Yeah, they need to keep pressing forward. They're just gonna get shot. Look, oh, they're getting shot at. Do they see him?
They've got to know they're up in the silo. Where else could they be getting shot at from? And there we go.
Okay. They're in.
That's one ally down. These axes, they're not messing around. They've got some nice high ground.
Oh, trade-off too.
Trade-off kill.
Yeah, team and Tent Derby Shire taking Benton down with him. So that's the Axis, you know, star rifleman there that was getting all the kills on Cachette Road.
Well, I guess that's one good guy down, but if it was Lieutenant Derbyshire that died for it, though, that's, I don't know if it's really worth it. I guess he's got to be getting desperate. He's got to make some plays, and he might have to jump into the game himself instead of just sitting back and leading. And I think that's what he did.
They're not going to get anything done with small little half-ass troops like that or squads like that. They need a real push.
And these guys are the Enfield. I just don't think they've got the firepower to take out these guys in silo. They're going up against a lot of guys in there. At least three or four. There we go. Get some more aggression from the allies coming up. That's what I like to see. I want to see a game.
This guy with the Tommy really, I'm not sure who it is, but he's in a great position with that gun.
And he is doing
Everyone's
work.
Everyone's got rifles, man.
Yeah, and this right here, the Tommy, he's knocked these guys out of their shooting positions. He has pushed them out, he scared them away, and they are not shooting at the allied approach anymore. It's beautiful suppression fire from him.
Well, the problem is there's no allies approaching, though.
Yeah, that's an issue. They got some allies in the buildings real close to the silo. Well, the buildings are right next to it, and I'm hoping the allies can
still
make some moves.
Is it just one guy or two?
I don't know. I can't see them. I think they might have retreated, honestly. I really don't know if that was the right call. I think they just need to go all in and clear this silo out. You got a Thompson against some K98s, I think.
Oh, you know what, though?
Should be able to handle it.
We got a master prone in silo watching the door, so.
See, that's maybe not the best idea to run it. Well, they can't know that. That's the issue, right? They know that they need to do something, and they can't know what they're going up against. I'm hearing some nice shooting. Lexan. Oh, picking off one of the big guns from the Axis team, Corporal Slomczynski. So you have the STG as well. I'm going to take a little peek. No, just a rifleman today. Not as big a victory as could have been. Axis tank.
Okay.
I don't know what they're shooting at, but they're shooting at something.
Wow, these guys are far more patient than I am.
And I guess it really comes down to the fact that they can't respawn. They understand that if they die here, they're gonna be out. They can't help their team anymore. And I think it's bringing a little bit of caution to their play. Sometimes the caution's good, sometimes it's bad. I guess we're going to have to wait and see if they get the win, right?
It's all about that W.
And it's been at least 30 minutes already, so time is passing for these guys. Yeah, taking this silo is going to be very difficult. Count 5, 6 axes in the silo right now. And they've got, I think, 4 more across the street.
Yeah, they really loaded
the Axis tank, Axis and Allied tank fighting each other somewhere. Let's see if we can find that.
Tommy, I want to find this Tommy.
Oh yeah.
Oh, there we go.
I just flashed by him.
I'm hearing him.
Oh,
he's not...
Tommy making moves in silo.
He's not effing around.
He's cleaning it up.
This is a hero play from Treble. Treble, out of this world play.
This is the game.
Out of this world. He has just saved the Allied game. This is what I want to see. Someone who makes the plays. knows what needs
Wow,
to be done.
impressive. That was sick. Great move. That needed to be made. And he made the shots too. I mean, like, think about it. Look where that MP40 is still on the ground on the stairs. That guy was camping there.
And whole Corporal Jessup, not happy about that at all. And he shouldn't be, really. PFC Treble, really, I can't say anything much better than, like, he might have won the game for the Allies. That was a beautiful, beautiful play. He
We'll
really
see.
should have been
There's
able to
still
do
lots of
that.
guys bunkered down. Lots of Axis guys still bunkered down in some nice buildings and nice defense spots. But definitely Silo was a big one, and that was a huge move.
Yeah, I really, it's crazy because I'm looking at Silo and I was thinking there's no way they're going to be able to take this without some tank fire, some good grenades. But one
Yeah,
man with a
agreed.
Thompson, if one man with a Thompson can do it, then one man with an MP40 or one man with an SDG can do it. So we're going to have to wait and see. Right, let's find these tanks. What is going on?
The Allied tank is at the church, and far away is the Axis tank, and they seem to have the general location of each other, and they're just trying to take pop shots at each other. I think the Allied tank may have gotten damaged, though, in the treads, so it's not able to move, but I'm not sure if that's confirmed or not.
He might just be stuck on that thing that he backed up onto. That would be
That's
embarrassing,
true. That's
but that
true.
might be
That's
what happened.
it's DH to do, and that's always risky moves.
Yeah, as you can see, the treads have directly entered the stairs and disappeared straight off the tank. And I'm not sure what this is. Is this some bad manners coming from this ally who's sitting on the back of the tank nonchalantly? It could be. We'll never know why he's
Trying
on
to
the
get
back of
under
that
the skin
tank.
of his opponents,
Yeah.
perhaps. Treble still doing work, a little bit of covering fire here and there as the one or two more allies move into the silo area.
And all this action shooting at these between these two tanks, they're so far away from each other. They've got a general idea, but hundreds of feet missing. But it's really not all that great. And this is
Earlier,
really the
the
big thing.
Axis was getting some pretty close shots. I think he had no idea if he was actually getting close or not, so he's just sort of picking random locations to shoot.
Above all else, the Axis tank has been kept busy. And you can see this allied squad has moved right up next to him. He was supposed to be watching this flank. This was his job, was to cover these fields, and the allied tank has scared him. Has scared him and has kept him busy, and these allies have now moved into position. And I can't see if either of these guys have. We're looking at the Piot. Their Piot is making a move. He is getting closer and closer to this Axis tank, and I can't see him not getting this Axis tank. He's snuck up. He's used his friendly tank for cover, and the allies, a late game resurgence. This is beautiful, beautiful late game play. If only they'd done this 30 minutes ago, right?
Yeah, well, it needed to be done, regardless, and yeah, I mean, better late than never.
Yeah, better late than never. In fact, it was just absolutely necessary. And this is beautiful play by this Axis tank. He says, "I don't know what's going on. I am pooping my pants. I have no ally, or I have no infantry to support me. So I'm gonna hide and wait for someone to come around this corner. This Piot, he's gonna come around this corner. He smells tank and he wants it. I'm just he's got the quicker reaction time." There's still fighting going on the main roads. I wish I could watch that, but I need to see if this tank's gonna get eliminated. This could be a game changer. And he missed. He whiffed it. Wow, that was not a good miss. Got one more chance, but I think he might want to get closer.
Couple small Axis losses to a failed grenade.
The Axis tank still doesn't see him. There it is. Axis tank is down, and the allies. I would argue the allies are now way in control of this game. Absolutely. In the.
Yeah, they're starting to establish a real presence on the main road. They got a force in Silo now, and everyone, all the Axis guys in the other buildings are just basically been held down.
Yeah, and the allies
Bren
making.
Garner. Oh, Bren just taken out in Silo. Someone's gonna need to come pick that gun up. Are they allowed to? Can they?
They definitely are allowed.
Okay, a treble, drop down the Tommy, pick up the Bren.
And that's actually Treble's weapon. Treble is really well renowned as one of the best Bren, best BAR users in all of the 29th. So they've just given him the best weapon he could ever want. He might prefer the FG if he could somehow scrounge one up from the enemies, but he's got...
Is there FGs in this map?
Yes, there is FGs. One more ally just got dropped.
Oh.
These guys are getting a bit too greedy in their positioning in these windows. And you go up against someone like Jarvanen. We watched Jarvanen earlier. Beautiful, beautiful positioning. Beautiful, beautiful use of the technique when needed. And he's just waiting for these allies to walk down those stairs. The allies
yeah,
might hold the
honestly,
silo.
Honestly, he's
bit.
Just been using really great angles. Just in the building, right across the road from Silo. He's been in there, I think, the entire game. And he keeps switching windows. And he's not right in the windows. He's keeping to the back of the room, and he's just looking for angled shots with the dummies that put their head up in the silo windows, and it's working for him.
And that's really what it is. It's just a dumb play by the allied team. They know this guy's here, picking him off, and they see the dead bodies, and they just keep walking into the same areas, and you know he's just gonna keep waiting, keep getting more kills.
Speaking of dummy moves, somebody just put their head up in silo, lost his helmet. Very lucky that guy.
He didn't die though. Ah, that is luck. Sir, First Sergeant, can you get a view on the Allied tank? I want to see what he's gonna do now that he's not afraid of an access tank.
All right, I found a easy way out of this building with a spectator cam. My player switch stopped working.
That's disappointing.
Yeah, I hate when that happens.
Zav, what tank is the are the Axis using? We got a question in the stream.
The Axis, they were using the short-barreled Panzer III, if I'm not mistaken. I'm not a tank expert, but I think it's the short-barreled Panzer III.
Okay.
It had a very short barrel. That's why I'm picking this name for this tank.
It's the Panzer III H, I believe.
There you go, Panzer III H. They really need to name their tanks things easier to remember, like the Juggernaut of Death. I'd remember a tank named the Juggernaut of Death.
Or the Elephant.
Yeah, it's a lot
that
easier
one has a simple
with,
name,
like,
I always
the,
remember that one.
It's a lot easier with, like, the King Tiger.
How could you forget the King Tiger? It had taken them 12 or 13 piots. It had taken them 12 or 13 piots to kill that thing. And I'm just hearing headshot after headshot today. These guys are... Oh, this is...
Right. Update on the Allied tank. It still has not left that church spot. It does have a damaged tread, but it was driving around a little bit earlier. I'm not sure if it's well enough to navigate through town. But the infantry from the church seem to be making a little bit of a push, so hopefully we'll see some more moves there.
And we actually just saw the Manson, the Axis sniper, with a beautiful... Beautiful rifle drop. Captain Cranston is rolling over in his grave right now thinking about how good this play is. PFC Manson gets rushed by the Sten and drops his rifle so he can pull out his pistol quicker and pistol the guy. Just absolutely
nice.
Phenomenal decision making on his part. And it's something you don't see a lot, so when you do see it, it's beautiful.
You're quite good at that move.
Oh, that's one of my specialties. I'm a big fan of the pistol drop. Every time I do it, I throw my arms up in the air and I point to Captain Cranston, who's up in heaven watching.
Because he died.
Because he hasn't been online in 3 days, so assume death.
He is dead, that's why.
Yes.
I'm actually going to feel really bad if he's actually dead. Danny. Sorry, Dan.
I hope he's not dead. I'd feel pretty bad, too. I'm getting some spectating. I call it an error, but it's darkest hour. Some spectating... features happening right now. Potter, ballsy run across the road. I wouldn't be doing that.
Okay, so I believe that most of the Axis forces defending the main road have backed up. I actually seen the one dude with the FG. He backed up quite a bit. And I don't really see too many of those guys anymore that were camping in those windows in the buildings. Oh, here we go. We got one MP40 in the building right after Silo.
Another headshot. What is going on with all these headshots today?
Another one.
Yeah, another guy lost his helmet. This is getting out of control.
There's helmets all over the floor.
Whoever designed...
Oh, another one!
Whoever designed these helmets is a hero.
Is this the same guy just, like, putting his helmet back on and then he keeps getting it knocked off?
It might be a glitch like that, but
this
people in Spectator calling
too,
it out as well.
He just got pinged, his helmet came off, and he didn't even move. He just stayed in the same spot.
And Trouble's got a bead down on Corporal Yarvinen. Corporal Yarvinen, smart man, keeping his head down, getting out of there.
I'm
hey,
not
he's
sure
going back.
How much I want to watch. Someone else just got domed again. Are you kidding me?
It might just be a bug. Where the same helmet keeps popping off.
I hope it is.
I hope it is. As I heard the helmet come off again. It's got to be a bug.
It's a good bug. It's just a nice sound to hear.
Yeah, it makes me feel a lot better about the fact
that... Oh, FG making a move in Silo. He's in.
Yeah, he is
downstairs. Keep an eye on him.
Got eyes. And this guy is going to try and replicate Trouble's run. If he can do the same amount of work that Trouble did. We could see a game change.
And he should. The FG is incredibly powerful for this kind of movement.
Yeah, and this is Oh, some Axis kills appear, and the Axis are making their final moves. With their tank down, they're gonna need to do some big time infantry plays. And I don't know what's gonna happen here. This has turned into a game. What started off as what appeared to be a stomp has turned into a real, real game.
Yeah, the Axis just got more aggressive out of nowhere. I feel like all of their guys are coming right out into the open.
I think they need to. I think this is do or die for both of these teams, really. The Allies only have, as far as I can see, two people up in the silo tower. So it's not like they're rolling in soldiers. This FG is... definitely more than enough to clear out both those guys. If he
he's
ever makes
very
his move,
cautious. He's being incredibly cautious, this guy. I'm getting a little sick of watching it. He's gotta go.
I mean,
and he's got a buddy right. If you look outside and over a little bit, there's a guy prone in the doorway, and he's got the guy with the Panzerschreck with him. And they could help him out.
And they are helping him out. Some Panzerschrecks going to the silo
yeah.
tower. Little oh, beautiful. He got him. I can only assume.
I don't think he did.
No, he got the kill. I'm seeing it up here. Sergeant Darlington just got picked off, and this is Rogers, who we were talking about earlier. Very good.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Very
good.
So
Treble's still in there, and he looks like he's alone now, right? Just
Treble is definitely alone in there. And
did the FG guy just get a kill?
Yes, he did. Looks like he's gotten the guys. Yeah, he moved into the building. He killed the last guy on the second floor, and there's Treble. No
there
chance.
Is.
Get out of my
he
house. Yeah, he knew.
That is his house, man. He claimed it.
Oh, it's his forever. This is no longer the Silo Tower. This is the Treble Hero Tower.
Okay, there's Rogers still hitting those windows. Seer, what's going on the other side of the map, buddy?
I've mostly just been watching the Allied defense here up by the silo.
I think everybody is. This is the exciting thing. We get to see Treble really just I don't know. Being the hero, being the champion, he's gonna need to step up though. He's gonna be going up against a lot. If they can get one good rocket into this building, he might die before even knowing, right? They can shoot it right through the wall and take him out. So. There's a lot to watch here. I'm really liking the patience on these axes. Very slow, methodical. Very slow, methodical they moved up. Very, 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 very patient. And it can go
either way.
All
right, we got a little squad of three guys here entering the silo. We'll see what how Treble handles this. He should be okay, man, with that Bren.
It really depends here. If he gets spotted by this... bazooka by the Panzerschreck. The Panzerschreck can shoot right through the floor and take him out. That's the big thing
Yeah,
he's got to
good
work
call.
for. If there's any time to suicide by shooting through the floor, it'd be now to take out PSC Treble. So, again, for those of you unfamiliar with Darkest Towers, pure mechanics. You can shoot through
Five
floors.
guys.
Five
Five
guys.
Germans working their way in a silo. This is intense.
Well, he
How,
took
where
out.
did they come from? How did this happen?
He took out five Germans to take the silo. Let's see if he can take out five Germans to hold it, right?
The action is getting red hot.
And where is he? Oh, he's got his, oh, he's about to see some danger here. He didn't see these guys come in because he was watching the other staircase.
Yeah. There
oh.
we go. One down. One,
one
down.
One down. One down. And he, oh, here we go. This is a very smart position by
Oh,
Treble.
Dude, that Germans, man, they moved in the back door.
Treble doesn't care.
One down, one down.
That, oh.
Another one. Wow, this is bringing out the harsh language from the privates. This is insane.
The Panzerschreck should have just taken a risk.
I agree. I think the Panzerschreck should have just gone for it.
He had the shot, more
yeah.
or less.
Suicide, backblast yourself off the floor. You got to get rid of this guy. This is, I again.
They
the
really
K98.
Need to go all in. You know what? He would have been dead if they all ran up and just went for it. But you know what? They went up a little bit at a time and they tried to split both doors. He picked two of them off and they backed off. And like you know, now they're even in a worse position.
Yeah, and this,
I don't agree with that choice.
A lot of this also comes down to these two K98s who, under the pressure, missed their shots. You know, he got shot at
yeah,
twice.
Yeah, for sure.
Either of these shots could have ended this. Could have won the
Especially
entire.
The first guy that went up the actual the wooden stairs. He had it.
He had a
the
freebie.
Shot, so.
He had a freebie. He could have lined up and
yeah.
iron sighted and just lined that shot up, but he waited for it. Is the grenade gonna be enough? Nope. Not enough. I'm not sure how many guys are left on each team. I'd really love to see it. And Treble, oh, he is fearless now. Oh, absolutely beautiful.
Oh,
he's got a pistol.
That's rifleman.
Oh my god. These guys, this isn't even Treble anymore. This is people making mistakes. He gave them the shots
yeah.
to the back, and they dropped the ball. They absolutely dropped the ball on Treble, and he's capitalizing on it. He's completely outnumbered. He should not be winning this, but when they drop the ball, Treble's not going to make a mistake. This guy doesn't make the errors. You make an error against him, you're dead. Looks like he's going to get another one when they come around the corner of this building. This is just out of control. It's great when you see a hero play like this sometimes. There's a nice grenade. Didn't prime it enough, though. Oh, looks like he did prime it enough. Was that Treble he got? I don't think so. No, PC coders. Treble with another kill. This is an absolute routing of the enemies. He is not giving them any chance to retreat, not giving them any chance to regroup. He's gone from the defensive to the I'm going to end this game now kind of ideas. And I got to give it to him. I think he's going to end this game now. When's the last time you've seen something like this in a scrim, First Sarge?
Not a long time.
This is really beautiful. This is reminding me of the some of the greats, the all-time greats. This is like a, I don't even know, it's like a Dullert play right here. It's just insane what's going on when I'm watching. It's like Davis has been resurrected as PFC Treble. And he's not given anyone any chance. This is a bit risky of him, though. He saw a machine gun in that building, and he's going to try and outrange them instead of rushing them. The Russian's been working pretty well for him, so I really wish that...
He's not Russian, he's German.
No, he's allied. He's Canadian.
Oh, yeah. Oops.
Joke failed on so many levels. It's okay, though. It's okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, this is...
I'm having more technical difficulties here, so I'm just trying to get back in the server.
And these technical difficulties. I mean, it's Darkest Hour after all. Phenomenal game. But it crashes. Don't all the good games crash, you know?
Well, not the well made ones.
No, I think it'd be fair. It is a mod. You know, Red Orchestra. The game is
yeah,
based
I'm just,
off of.
I'm just joshing.
You're joshing around. All right. And we're following Treble here because You want to see some action, you follow trouble. I guess that's the motto of the story. I missed him clearing out the building. I don't want to miss anything else from this guy. I'm hearing some shooting somewhere else, so let's see if I can get a spot on what's going on over here. Potter, I'm going to assume it's Garvin in or somebody still fighting from that building across the street. The Allies holding, I really hope the Allies are holding Silo because they had it before trouble ran out of it. I don't think anybody's in Silo.
Oh, there's a GG from Lita.
Lita, early GGs.
Is that an aggressive GG?
I don't know, I think it's more of a this is actually a good game. Because this has been a good game. Unexpected. Over and over again, unexpected. I'm still surprised those five axes couldn't take care of business.
They really played wrong.
Yeah, I think that's really the best way to put it. Is
that was hard to watch. The split up the stairs was... I was impressed by that. The first guy came up the stairs, and of course, trouble got him because that's the stairs he was camping. But man, those other guys should have just rushed right up, and they did. But really, they backed off, and it was all a mess. They should have been way more aggressive there. Their goal should have been kill him, no matter what the cost is. Just run and kill.
Yeah, because at worst, the cost was everybody, and they still didn't kill him. So yeah, at any cost would have been great. And I'm not sure they played wrong. I think the pressure just got to them. They set it up beautifully. You had one guy come up one staircase, the other guy come up the other staircase, almost in sync. The problem was that the guy coming up the other staircase missed. Maybe they should have had the MP40 go up instead. The guy with the bazooka could have traded his MP40 to the guy with the K98 and given him a little bit of a bonus.
I really think they could have just did anything as long as they got up there and they were shooting their guns.
Yeah, and when he came down on them, that was another chance they had. Three or four misses with a K98, though. You just can't be doing things like that if you want to get the win. And
okay, so where is he now since I've left?
I'm not sure. I might have actually crashed. Oh, no. Bullets are happening. Everything is fine. I wasn't sure if I'd crashed because I hadn't heard anything in a while. And I'm... Oh, spectator's working again. Thank you, spectating gods.
Okay, here's our friendly neighborhood German MG. Haven't seen him in a while. Still in the same building he was in at the beginning of the game there when he was shooting down the road.
And this is him either listening to orders extremely well or being very fearful because even with just a pistol, there's not a lot you can do. At the end of the day, I'm sure he was told to get in this building, so he's doing what he's told. But at this point,
I feel like
he
the
needs
longer
to do something.
He stays there, the more trouble he's... Yeah, exactly. He needs to do something.
He really needs to make something happen. I'm not sure how many guys are left on Actus.
Just get into a better position.
There can't be more than three or four, right?
Yeah, that's kind of tough. You can't really, you can't keep track of, or you'd have to keep track of everyone dying. And
yeah, Golob, he's really just not, he's really not doing much of anything. I guess he's got a very nice spot on this bed, backed out from the window, so he's harder to see. But he's just blind firing, and he doesn't actually see anybody. He's just guessing. Guessing can work for you sometimes, but I don't know if it's going to be enough.
He's just giving away his position.
Yeah, and trouble again is just waiting for him. He's still up in that window. Just poke your head out. Poke your head out, I'll take you. He's not getting the right windows to shoot him in, though. From what I can see, we've got Golob, PFC Golob in the blue house. The house he's been in all game. We got PFC Potter in the Silo Tower itself. We've got PFC Treble up in front of the Silo Tower, the building in the front right of the Silo Tower. I don't have a compass, or I'd give you some compass directions on where it is, but I think that's all. Oh, and we've got one more ally of unknown name over in the other side of the silo. I'm just looking for any access other than PFC Golob. He might be the last guy left, and he's making moves.
I flashed you some access, but I went past him accidentally. They're running through a field somewhere.
All right. Golob getting shot at. Didn't get hit, though. And he's in a much better position to fire on the silo tower now. This is much, much better.
Yeah, here we go. I found the axis. They're running along the Brettville Road.
Brettville Road. Big in flying around.
Yeah. And the field's to the north of the Brettville Road right there.
Alright, we're going to wait to see what they do. I'm not sure how much time is left. I should have been keeping a timer. Have you been timekeeping?
Me? No, I haven't.
There's a timer in the top right corner, top left.
Yes, I'm just not sure when they started. I don't think they didn't start at 9:99.
I got an update from First Lieutenant Browning that it is going to be 8 minutes left.
8 minutes left, and that's enough time for these axes to actually get to the silo tower and do some work. So, we've got one MG across from the silo. We'll give it a call of the southeast. My mistake. And then we've got two axes approaching from the northern side. And they're right up on the silo, and there's nobody from the Allies watching this. They know that the pressure's on. They're taking a risk, just running through, but nobody's watching. It's very low numbers on both sides. This is a ridiculously good game.
And you can hear them in chat. They know their position. They know what they've got right now.
Yeah, they definitely do. All right, these two axes.
Yeah, they're closing in.
And Treble is not in the silo itself. There's two Enfields in this silo. Treble is in a different building. And oh!
I just heard the brand.
There it is. The Allied forces. Treble! He's not messing around, is he? Yeah, he's across the road with two pickoffs. What's the official count on that? I think that's 12 or 13 kills for Treble this game. That was ridiculous.
That is 14.
14 kills. I've never seen a performance like that in my entire life. Half the team. A kudos for myself to Treble. Thank you, Treble, for showing me one of the best games of my life.
Everyone on Allies, please.
Wow. We're just going
to
get...
It was really that Tommy move at the beginning. That was it.
And that's really something to be more impressive even, is he didn't just do this with one weapon. He went in there with the Thompson, he cleaned it up, he picked up the Brent, and then he repeated his performance. Just, I'm actually fanboying over Treble. Put me in the Treble fanboy club right now.
Number one fan, it sounds like.
Number one fan. I've never seen anything like that. That was just beautiful. A lot of luck involved, but hey... All video games have a little bit of luck involved, so he took the luck and he used it. We're going to go into a little bit of a D-wrap here, but this is actually the end of the scrim. So we watched BP2 with the victory today. And I don't know what to say other than, like, congratulations, guys. You really pulled through, especially when I thought it was over for them. I feel bad now. I feel like, you know, I'm calling the game GG. These guys lost, you know, they've haven't gotten a kill and they've already lost 8 or 9 guys. And damn.
I don't think you should feel bad. It was looking actually really grim until Treble came in with the Tommy and really cleaned up Silo. Like that was huge. That was a lot bigger than. We got to remember how big that was. So and then everything after that was just due to the fact that he grabbed that great position. And he just defended well. After that was just a series of mistakes by Axis trying to handle him. And he just became on fire because of it.
Okay. So, I would like to warn so many squad leaders who have people in their squad who can't hear me right now.
While we're waiting for this, I just wanted to say, you know, thank you.
Very good. Okay. So, that is a victory for BP2. Congratulations, BP2. That was a really, really intense match. I got a few of the highlights written down, and I think we all know what the big highlight of this match was. That's PFC Treble. PFC Treble, that was pretty incredible. I saw you take out 5 guys. I think when you entered the silo, saw you defend it against 4 guys, then go on the offensive and take out another 2 guys. Then you went chasing the MG, but the MG had moved, so you went back to the silo tower and defended it against another two guys. I count 14 kills. I might have missed one or two even. Let's see, what else? Oh yeah, PFC Rufus, in the Axis tank. PFC Rufus, you got to tell me, how did you know where the Allied tank was? Because I saw you shoot at the Allied tank well, well beyond fog range, and you managed to take its tracks off. That was pretty impressive. Oh, okay. Lots of skills, maybe a little bit of luck, perhaps.
He's humble, too.
I also saw PFC Lay with his spear come and take out the tank. That was impressive as well. Oh, and one last thing, I saw PFC Manson. PFC Manson was with his sniper, and he was surprised by an SMG. And so he did the Cranston quick drop, and pulled out his pistol, and managed to defend himself.
Wow, Cranny, you're really getting that shout-out.
Pretty impressive. Okay, I'm sure the platoon leaders will be writing up a debrief, which you'll be able to read early next week. Once again, congratulations to BP2. I will see you all next week, if not sooner. You're all dismissed.
All right, and that's the end of the match for everybody. Hope the guys that were spectating enjoyed it. Really, a great match, honestly. A lot of suspense and a lot of back and forth. And I think you really summed it up when you said, Dave, that when Treble made his move, it wasn't just that he made his move that won the match. It was the fact that his team said, let's capitalize on this. He made the move. Let's capitalize. Let's take our positions and let's put the nail in the coffin. That's what they did. Really, really stellar, stellar game. And I'm so happy that this is the first game that I streamed that wasn't a stomp. I was getting really worried at first that, oh, wow, the first scrim that we're streaming is going to be a really bad stomp and it's not going to be fun. But no, it was a great match.
Yeah, it ended up being an interesting one.
All right, well, I'm going to end this soon. So any final words for Sergeant?
Not really for me.
What about you, Dave? How'd you find your
no
first 29th event?
No final words here. All right. It was fun. It was really fun to watch that. It was cool to see how things work from the inside. I want to thank you for having me. I want to thank the 29th. I love the 29th. I love Darkest Hour. It was, you know, I hope we could do more of this in the future, but it's just nice to see things happening with Darkest Hour. And yeah, thank you.
Yeah, no, and thank you for being here. I mean, we asked you to come in and be an outside perspective on what we do within the 29th. And I know you're making time out of your busy schedule to actually come here and do this. So
yeah, you know me. You know how busy I am.
Yeah, thanks for being here. And
you joined your channel.
Yeah, I want to thank everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. The 29th, we do these things all the time. If you're interested in becoming a part of the 29th, just head over to our website, 29th.org, and click on the enlist button. It'll set you all up, and you can become a part of the 29th. We accept almost anyone, as long as you have a passion for team play, and you're a good person, really. So head on over if you're interested, and hopefully we'll be able to stream a couple more matches in the next coming weeks. See everyone.